Since the early ages, humankind has consulted oracles, for example, the Oracle of Delphi. People look to the stars to seek their destiny. Witches or wise women used to read the future in tea leaves or tortoise shells. Here we use your tarot deck as a tool for meditation to help us move to the present, from the head to the heart. Osho, why are we continually avoiding this moment?
There has been a great misunderstanding between life and time. Time is thought to be consisting of three tenses: past, present, future, which is wrong. Time consists only of past and future. It is life which consists of present. So those who want to live for them, there is no other way than to live this moment. Only the present is existential. Past is simply a collection of memories, and future is nothing but your imaginations, your dreams. Reality is here now. Those who want just to think about life, about living, about love, for them past and future are perfectly beautiful because they give them infinite scope. They can decorate their past, make it as beautiful as they like, although they never lived it. When it was present, they were not there. These are just shadows, reflections. They were continuously running, and while running they have seen few things. They think they have lived. In the past, only death is the reality, not life. In the future also, only death is the reality, not life. Those who have missed living in the past automatically to substitute the gap, start dreaming about the future. Their future is only a projection out of the past. So whatever they have missed in the past, they are hoping in the future. And between the two non-existents is the small existent moment, which is life. Those who want to live, not to think about, but to love, not to think about it, but to be, not to philosophize about it. There is no other alternative. Then drink the present moment's juices. Excuse it totally, because it is not going to come back again. Once gone, it is gone forever. But because of the misunderstanding which has been almost as old as man, and all the cultures have joined into it, they have made present part of time, and present has nothing to do with time. If you are just here in this moment, there is no time. There is immense silence, stillness, no movement. Nothing is passing. Everything has come to a sudden stop. The present gives you the opportunity to dive deep into the waters of life, or to fly high into the sky of life. But on both the sides there are dangers, past and future are the most dangerous words in human language. Between past and future, living in the present is almost like walking on a tight rope. On both sides there is danger. But once you have tasted the juices of the present, you don't care about dangers. Once you are in tune with life, then nothing matters. And to me, life is all there is. You can call it God, but that is not a good name, because religions have contaminated it. You can call it existence, which is beautiful. But what you call is not of any consequence. The understanding should be clear that you have only one moment in your hands. The real moment. And you will get another moment again. Either you live it or you leave it unlived. Most of the people simply drag from their cradle to the grave without living at all. I have heard about a Sufi statement that a man, when he died, suddenly realized, "My God, I was alive." But only death, as a contrast, made him aware that for 70 years he has been alive, but life itself has not enriched him. It is not the fault of life. It is our misunderstanding. My insistence for watchfulness will give you life without even thinking about it, because watchfulness can only be in the present. You can witness only the present. Live totally and live intensely, so that each moment becomes golden and your whole life becomes a series of golden moments. Such a person never dies, because he has the Midas touch. Whatever he touches becomes golden. When he touches death, death also becomes golden. He enjoys it as much as life, or perhaps more, because death is more condensed than life. Life is spread on 70, 80 years. Death happens in a single moment. It is so condensed that if you have lived your life rightly, you will be able to enter into the mystery of death. And the mystery of death is that it is only a cover. Inside is your immortality, your eternal life.